Beside mine. Because it's like. Welcome to Amsterdam. So this time around, I'm just gonna bring you to explore Amsterdam on what to eat, and so it's a vlog focused on food. They have some very unique kind of food, like pancake, but it's a different type of pancake from us, and like some herring or fish's sashimi kind of thing. So I'll show you what food they have here, and I will go to the first stop now. It's a long queue. This is the queue. Hopefully it's good. Here's the menu. So they sell a lot of omelets and egg stuff. Juices. Yes. The queue is actually quite fast. So it's gonna be my turn soon. While waiting, I just wanna add on. The weather here is crazy. So it was very sunny just now, and suddenly rain like crazy, and then now it's sunny again. And I hope it stays this way and rain go away. So this is the omelette with onions and something else, I forgot. It always comes with a salmon and a bread. And there's a cordon with butter. Sometimes this is tea with mint leaves, and they give this coffee. Okay. The omelette is good, super fluffy and well done. It's like still juicy. Perfection. And definitely, if you come to Amsterdam, you have to check them out. It's on a pricier side, like it's like a cafe food price. Yeah. But definitely worth it. The queue is quite fast also, it's about 15 minutes. Round 2 please. Which is the seafood bar. Okay, they just on the light. And gonna check out how fresh is the seafood. The review is not too bad. So gonna do seafood tonight. I'll show you in a while. Alright, so here's the menu. It's a crazy huge ass menu. So they did introduce some fishes that are fresh, and even the Alaska king crab leg. And I'll see what I want to order. So it's a bit too overwhelming for me now. Massive plate of seafood platter. There's crab, prawn, clam, mussels, and oysters. I'm done with the seafood bar, and it's awesome, super good. Definitely recommend anybody who come Amsterdam to try them out. So what I ordered was the fresh seafood. They are actually cooked besides the oyster, but they serve cold in the ice, and it's like sweet, very nice. I'll bring you to the next place tomorrow morning, and I'm going to bring you to the third location. This is the pancake that I previously mentioned, so probably it's gonna have some sweet pancake, and I'll show you later. It's damn cool, so this is my outfit. This has my pink. You have options to choose your own and create your pancakes also. So I'm sitting outside because inside is very packed and the smell is actually very strong. So it's more ideal to sit outside, even though it's quite cold, but just get to enjoy the cool breeze and the view. Hot chocolate. This mini one with caramel. So this is bacon and apple and the fried egg. So I'm done with breakfast. Honestly, it's very good. but the pancake is a bit on the doughy side. It's not like the very fluffy kind that we have. Yeah, it's quite interesting. And it's very basic, honestly. So it's just really bacon, apple. I personally like it. And I will come back. So next up, we're gonna eat her Indonesian cuisine for lunch. And I'm gonna try what's the difference over here as compared to Asia. The vibes here is amazing. Here we go, there's satay. I forgot what. Chicken, egg, coconut veggie again, chips, some nuts, and this is coconut as well. And cucumber served with rice. And that's it. So I forgot to summarize my previous meal, which is the Indonesian food, because I was rushing for Anne Frank house. Overall, it's a bit jelak sometimes because it's like it's very heavily sauced and a lot of coconut as well. But in general, it's still very good lah. So if you are bored of like Western food or something, you can try. So now I'm walking to the dinner place, and this time around my dinner is gonna be a one Michelin star restaurant. I think it's my first time having Michelin star restaurant, so I'm gonna try it out, and I hope it's really good and worth the price. It's called the Dutchness Amsterdam and is in W Amsterdam Hotel. Wrap up on the dinner just now. It is okay. I feel that the best one was the escargot and the pasta. Beef Wellington, I personally feel it's not too bad. I don't think I will go again, but it's a good experience and the staff are really friendly and helpful. So they introduce the food to you also. You can ask them for recommendation as well. So if you have a bit more budget, you can check them out. My total bill is about 200 euros, I think. Good night. And I'll feed the cookie. And go for the first meal, which is waffles and croissant. And it's called Rinse. This is a sandwich I got. And also some donuts.
The bread is very hard, but the feeling inside is good. Otherwise, it's good. I just got used to this bread, I think.
Location we have Nam Ki, and it's Asian food again, but the queue is long here. Go for it. Done with dinner, and personally I feel it's meh. The total bill was about 73, and I feel not really worth it lah. But like if you miss Asian food, you can try them out. It's not bad for a standard, but it's just not something that I would try again. Yeah, and that's about it for today. I had lunch at Fufu Udon because of the weather is really cold, so decided to have some soup. And yeah, the first thing came across my mind is like noodle soup or something like that. So I had udon, and it's pretty good. It's a little pricey. It's like 17 euros, but it's a huge bowl and definitely very filling. So I'm gonna walk around the area, and I will see what to bring you to eat next. Yeah. This is their special ramen. So it looks kind of foamy, and this comes with seaweed, pickled veggie, and corn. So yesterday the ramen was just actually next beside my hotel, and yesterday so it's just a chill day. And overall the ramen is actually quite good, and it's very comforting for the weather. You see, today is a rainy day, and to say it's good morning, so I'm gonna grab some sandwich over here. Sandwich shop, Amsterdam. So I ordered the ginger lemon tea. Actually, just warm water. They always give this as little bites for drinks. This is what she recommended me. Some ham meat. This is served warm. Perfect. Plus this coffee bowl. And this is how you order. You choose what you want, like burger, and then you just tap. And that's it. Quick and easy. So this is like, this is called creme bouton, and this is deer meat. So I'm gonna give it a try. Pho king for dinner, and it's very good for the weather again. So Asian food. Which is the herring, very popular. The queue is very long. Yes, and gonna try it. So this is the herring, pickles, and yeah, it's very good.
It's not fishy.
It's not what?
Fishy.
But the bad thing is like the bones. And overall it's very good. Have to try.
Welcome.
Hi. It's the next location, which is dinner at Food Talent. Yeah, hope there's a lot of choices. So this place is like a messy food court with some like band, song, food. There's a lot of Asian food actually. Probably gonna order some fresh oyster, some balan ball, which is the world thingy, the local cuisine, and see what else we can order lah. So order some sweets and drinks so that we can sit at the bar. It's very hard to find a seat here, so this is the menu for it, and you can see in the bar. So this is Jintan, and this is the Salam bar. Taking a break from Amsterdam, and now I am at Rotterdam for lunch. It's actually 4 already, but I'm gonna check this market out, which is called the Martel or something like that, and I will show you what I'm gonna have. So it's like a place with a lot of stores, but it's not like a food court, so you have to either take away or eat at the store itself. This is like grilled seafood. This is prawn biryani. Yes. Mussel pan. Ta-da! So I'm done with the food, and the mussel is the best, I feel. And this is the cube house. So make a guess. It's the floor flat. It's the ground flat. I don't know. But maybe they will like lie on the window, you know, because it's like
stop it, get some help.
shop at Rotterdam is the Food Helen again. And this is a smaller Food Helen, not like the one in Amsterdam. But the vibes is still pretty good. So we're gonna try the Indonesian food and some tacos and maybe some fried stuff. And I will show you in a while. So this is the chopile beef taco and this is the fried shrimp.
Look at the chips, like banana shape.
This is the ayam soup and rice. Some banana leaf thingy with chicken or something.
The herbal is chicken, cauliflower, bell pepper. The beef is a bit sour. The texture is mushy. Kind of weird. Not really to my liking. Maybe it's like special flavors.
And today is the last stop and it's a market. We're supposed to go on Sunday but it is closed on Sunday. There's a lot of market on that's closed on Sunday. Like Sunday is their maybe family day or something. So now I am at Tupai, the station, and gonna walk to Alba Cup Market, I think. That's the pronunciation, I think. So the market is right outside the station and thank God it's not very packed. It's a huge bubble tea and very nice decor dim sum shop. So this market mainly has clothing, food and some artsy foxy stuff like painting or like handmade accessories. Like the wet market, so there's crab, there's fishes. I'm gonna hunt for some food now. So we're finally getting this mini pancake that I don't know how to pronounce. And I'm gonna go for a small one so you can try more food later. Nice! Hot chocolate for the weather! And the guy was very fancy and he was doing all the stunts and he loved the camera. So, fun fact is I don't drink coffee and I can't because I'm very sensitive and when I drink it I feel very nauseous. And we'll move to the next food! Mushroom from Germany.
Why are you eating in the forest?
Yeah.
No words?
Oh, see. Very juicy. And tastes like nothing. Basic, yeah, basic. I would say it's very basic.
Now we are gonna have Benny's chicken. It's a full chicken, so honey. Good. Excited! It's a full ass chicken and some spicy sauces. Gonna try it. It smells so good.
Because it's raining and so we are hiding in the supermarket and also to get some stuff back home. And just a overall wrap up on Amsterdam. Food is good, humans are good, people are very nice, very helpful, and they all speak in English, very good English actually. So communication is not a problem here. And what's my favorite food here so far? I like the pancake, I like the herring. I love the seafood here, especially the oyster. It's so good, like everything is so fresh. And what else? Let me think. Yeah, but things are actually a little bit expensive. But I guess it's holiday, and if you are getting like tax refund. Usually it's about 10% for clothing, and the clothes here are, the choices here are very good, and so I did quite a bit of shopping. And I'm gonna show you around the market if possible, and I will see you on my next vlog. Bye bye.
Okay, cool.